Welcome to our channel, Right Click Education. If you haven't subscribed our channel, please subscribe to get more updates. So today we will learn how to implement Angular Material Select. So let's get it started. Type Angular Material in your Chrome browser. Click on this Angular Material official website, that is material.angular.io. Click on component. If you see in the left sidebar, right, you have lot of elements. Today we will learn how to implement this select. Select is widely used in order to implement the forms. Whenever you have a lot of options to select and you want to select one of them, you can use select box for it. So let me show you how it looks like in Angular Material. Click on it. You can see you have a lot of options. You can select any of it, right? It gets selected. So today we will know how, I will give you basic overview how you can implement Angular Material select box. I will give you the two cases. One is using some hard coding, another how you can dynamically select from the select boxes. Okay, so let's get straight back to the coding part. Click on the API, copy this match select module. Okay, go to your VS Code, paste it here, copy this match select module, paste it inside this import section of ng module. Okay, and also if you are getting any kind of import errors, please once check this browser animation module. This should be imported. If it is not imported, please import this using npm install @angular/animations. Okay, so then you won't get any importing errors. So now since we have imported match select module, we are good to implement the HTML part. So let's do it. First of all, you need to put this select box inside mat form field. Okay, so let's do it. Okay, now I will also give some mat lib. Okay, so that it will tell us what level it is selecting. Let's say we will give a list of fruits, or suppose we will give list of favorite food and we will select one of them. Okay, so favorite foods. Okay, now we will give mat select. Okay, and to give the multiple option, we will give mat option. Okay, so let's give some food name, suppose pizza. I hope you like pizza. Copy it. We will give some fast foods that we regularly eat. I am very foodie person, so let's give burger. Let's also give pasta. Let's also give our Indian food, biryani. Okay, so now let's get to the localhost 4200 to see how it looks like. Okay, go to Chrome, open localhost 4200. If you see here, right, the select board, you can see a drop down with the label favorite food. If you click on it, you can see there are four options. So you can select any of it. Why it's not getting selected? So let's see how it's not getting selected. Okay, so what we will do, we will provide value equals to pizza. Okay, let's copy this thing, paste it. Copy this biryani, paste it here, copy this pasta, copy this pasta, paste it here, copy this burger, paste it here. Okay, now let's see if it gets selected or not. So click here. Now you can see, right, this is getting selected, right? So in this way you can select the hard-coded options. Okay, so you have MAT form field. Inside MAT form field you will have select, and inside select you have the options. Okay, now we will dynamically render the list of values that is there in the MAT select. For that, what we will do, we'll remove all this. Okay, we will also remove this one also. This one also. We will run a for loop, okay, which is ng for equals to let food of foods. What it will do, so food is an array which will have all the favorite foods, and food will loop through this foods array and it will give you the each value of that array. Okay, so let's bind it so that we can. So let food of foods, so we will bind food here. Okay, and value equals to food. Okay, so and we need to create this foods array, but in order to save some time, I've already created the foods array. Let's add some more food to it. Pasta. Biryani. Okay, so we have this. Now let's go and see how it looks like. What you can see, it's distorted, right? You can have this, you have this four or five drop down here. So what we have done, we have implemented this for loop at the wrong place. Okay, so let's cut it, paste it here. Okay, let's make our code a little bit of understandable. Now let's get back to UI. So if you see here, right, you have these options, we are looking through the array and we are selecting any one of the option, right? So in this way you can implement the mat select. So what you have to take care, I have shown you the use cases and some of the error that we usually get. So inside mat form we have this mat select, and inside this mat select we have mats option, okay? And inside this mat option you can bind the every element of food, that is food. So what we are doing, we are looping through this foods array and we are binding this food to here, so that it will loop through this foods array and take every element at a time, and it will render in the select box. Okay, so it's clear. And also you can make appearance equals to outline. Okay, so you can say it's something like box. Now it's looking much better, right? So that's it for this video. And if you haven't subscribed our channel, please do subscribe channel to get more updates. Keep visiting our channel. Thanks and have a nice day.